Okay, today we are going to talk about the mating of the haploid yeast cells. The yeast cells, they are one of the most important microorganisms in the field of biological sciences. They have been used in the experiments of genomics, the genetic engineering, the understanding of the eukaryotic cell cycle, and many more processes. But today we are specifically going to talk about the mating of the haploid yeast cells. If you look at the yeast cells, they can exist in two forms. They can exist in diploid form, they can exist in the haploid form. Now, when the conditions they are normal, by that I mean when the nutrients they are available, you have got the nutrients over here, you have got all of the other requirements for the growth and division of the yeast cell that usually prefer this diploid form. But when the conditions they are abnormal, by that I mean when there is deficiency of the nutrients, these diploid cells, they usually go towards the haploid form by the process of meiosis. Now, in these haploid cells, they are of two forms. One is known as the A cell, the other one that is known as the alpha cell. So, during the abnormal condition, the diploid form of the yeast, they move towards the haploid form. And there are two kinds of the haploid cells, the A cells and the alpha cells. Now, you have got the A cells in the environment, you have got a lot of the alpha cells in the environment. So when the conditions, they become normal, these haploid cells, they are going to mate with each other to give rise to the diploid form of the cells. Now, the question is that which kind of the haploid cells they are going to mate with each other, because in the environment you have got two different kind of the haploid cells. Now, theoretically, there can be three possibilities. The first one is that an A cell is going to interact with the A cell, one haploid A cell, one haploid A cell, to give rise to the diploid cell. An alpha cell can combine with an alpha cell to give rise to a diploid cell, or an A cell can combine with an alpha cell to give rise to a diploid form. Now, if you look at the first two options, they are not executed during the formation of the diploid cells from the haploid cells. Only the A haploid cell will combine with an alpha haploid cell to give rise to a diploid cell. Now, what is the reason that an A cell cannot interact with an A cell to give rise to a diploid cell, or an alpha cell cannot interact with an alpha cell to give rise to a diploid cell? If you look at the signaling mechanisms, in signaling, the general rule is that there will be a ligand, you can also call this as a signal, and there will be a receptor. So if the ligand and the receptors, they are there, they are going to interact with each other, but a specific ligand can only interact with a specific receptor. So you have got a specific interaction of specific ligands or signals to specific receptors. You can compare this with the specific interaction of the ligand and the receptor to the interaction of the enzyme and the substrate interaction. If you look at a cell, in the cell you have got a lot of substrates over here, a lot of substrates they are there, and you have got a lot of enzymes in these cells. But the enzymes out of these total substrate can interact with a specific substrate. They do not interact with all of the substrates. Similarly, every substrate is not going to interact with every enzyme, because the enzyme-substrate interaction, that is very specific. Same is the case over here, that specific ligand or signal interacts with a specific receptor. And this is the reason why only an A cell can interact with the alpha cells. Now let us discuss this in a little bit detail. If you look at the A cell, the A cell that produces specific mating factor known as pheromone, but the specific pheromone produced by the A cell is known as an alpha factor. Similarly, The alpha cell, they are producing a specific mating factor known as pheromone, but this the pheromone produced by the alpha cell is known as the alpha factor. The second thing is that the A cell, they are going to produce a specific receptor on their surface, and that particular receptor is known as the STE2 receptor. If you look at the alpha cell, the alpha cell is going to produce a specific receptor on its surface, and that particular receptor is known as the STE3 receptor. Now, the E factor produced by the A cell can only interact with the STE3 receptor. Similarly, the alpha factor produced by the alpha cell can only interact with the STE2 receptor. Now, that means that the receptor for the A factor is present on the alpha cell. The receptor for the alpha factor is present on the A cell. Now, that is the reason that only an A cell can interact with an alpha cell. Now, if you look at the first condition where you have got the A cell and an A cell. Now, if the A cell produce a pheromone, if this A cell produce a pheromone and they do not find any kind of the receptor for interaction, those particular pheromones are not going to interact with these cells to produce a cellular response. Same is the case over here. If this is producing a pheromone, this is producing a pheromone, but if there is no receptor, it means there will be no interaction of the alpha cell to another alpha cell. If you look at specifically over here, the A cell is producing a pheromone, but the receptor for this is present on the alpha cell, it means that the A cell pheromone is going to interact with this cell. Similarly, the pheromone produced by this particular alpha cell, the receptor is present on the A cell, and that particular pheromone is going to interact with the A cell because the receptor that is there. Now, that is the reason that out of these three possibilities, only this particular strategy, the interaction of the haploid A cell and the haploid alpha cell, they combine with each other during the normal condition to give rise to a haploid, diploid cells. Now, the E cell, they produce a particular protrusion known as schmoo. The alpha cell, they are going to produce a particular protrusion known as the schmoo. And as you can see over here, if this is the A cell, if this is the alpha cell, this is the protrusion produced by the alpha cell, this is the protrusion produced by the A cell, and the A cell is going to combine with the alpha cell to give rise to a diploid cell in the normal condition. I hope this clarifies the situation why the alpha cell can only interact with the A cell and the A cell can only interact with the alpha cell. If you like this video, please subscribe this. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates or more topics about the biology.